Islam family, peace and love. I am Yusuf Nasir Bey, here in northwest of Maxim. I just want to address an issue that are here in northwest of Maxim. I know a lot of people are planning protests and marches and things of that nature. And I just want to inform the people that there would be no need for marches if you were in your proper status in law, because marching does nothing but wear out your shoes, you know, because in a dead status, in the belief that we are Negroes, Blacks, Coloreds, ETC, African Americans, so on and so forth, we are being abused. Our rights are not being upheld, or we don't know the law enough to uphold people to the oath of the Constitution, the law of this land. And I just want to explain to the people who may be going out there protesting and marching you are going out there protesting and marching in a dead status, and it's a warship status. I'm going to read a little something to you from this book. It's called Warship Dispeller, Back to Basics, by Master Teacher Taj Sharik Bey, published by through rvbeypublication.com. Now, what is ward? What is wardship? Ward is a legal status, condition, and military term, which means to keep under guard, to keep under watch, to keep in custody, etc. The social and political operational position of U.S. demo slaveholders and birthright thieves is that of wardens or ward keepers, the occupying political powers. Because here in Northwest America, Northwest Amexum, we are under occupation from inquisitional forces and political powers. The ward term is politically used to apply to those who have been held to forced servitude and to civil little mortus. This social status is wardship, which is a military tenure involving the claimed right of the Lord to have custody as a guardian of the body and lands of a defeated natural person or minor or infant without any account of profits. This has much to do with the demo Europeans artfully choosing the pseudo-identity practice of branding so-called Blacks, Negroes as minorities and burying the political concept of our free national name. Ward, as used in this text, is a person or infant who is placed or held by authority of law under the guard or care of a guard or guardian. In the nature of colonial occupation of the Americas, the indigenous natural peoples are held under a color of law, not de jure law. Color of law are code, statutes, and ordinances placed on the natural people who have been stripped of their natural name, the national free appellations, that is. And we are under spells, because spelling is a part of the grammatication and linguistics, which treats of the forming of words or putting words together and the study of this art. Spelling also involves the art of casting spells by charm, by irresistible influences, by hallucinations, by fascinations, etc., miseducation, misdirection, or the preferred negative literary arts of spell casting, and have been systematically applied by inquisitionists through their military and paramilitary colonial institution outposts. The U.S. demo European colonizers at North America are the corporate political seat of the Inquisition outposts. Okay? So, these terminologies that have been placed on us, Negro, Black, Colored, African American, are fictitious misnomers. They're what you call nom de guerre. They're war terminology, war tenures, war names that have been placed on our people as our nationalities were taken away from us because we honor not our forefathers and foremothers. Okay? Now, to further address people who are going out here marching in a dead status, when if you're in your proper status, you would not have to do marching at all. Okay? Because the denotative, connotative, and social political applications of the word Negro and Black. In another book I'm referencing, the U.S. Nigger Industry, the corporate person, food for the vampires, by Taj, again, master teacher Taj Tariq Bey, published again by rvbeypublication.com. And I want to give you a little demonstration here on the denotative and the connotative and social political applications of Negro, the word Negro and Black. Black, absence, pardon me here, Black, absence of all moral light or goodness, evil, wicked, Black, characterized by the absence of light, to be involved or enveloped in darkness, Black, gloomy, dismal, a Black outlook, Black, boiling, boarding, ill, sullen, sinister, distress, disastrous, pardon me, banful, forbidding, Black words, Black looks, Black, colluded with anger, threatening, and indicating disgrace, ingratitude, Black, civil little more twos, again, dead in the eyes of the law, no status in law. When you're civil little more twos, you're outside the constitutional fold of government. You have no protection of the constitution of this government. Okay? Black, caused or marked by ruin or desolation. Black, indicating censure, disgrace, or liability to punishment, a Black mark. Black means to lose consciousness. And it proves it. We prove it every day by running around here calling ourselves Black, that we are unconscious. And unconscious means simply just that you're asleep to the fact, the truth of who we are as a people. And we're running around here being abused by other citizens when the Constitution is here to protect us from other citizens. But we must first learn these things. Black, to sully and to defame. Black, to paint, stain, to varnish, or dye. That's Black, you know? And all is defamation. There's nothing glorious about being Black. Black power, there's no power in the construct, that fictional construct. Black color, you know. And furthermore, I'm gonna read here in this Webster's New World Dictionary, okay? Pardon me one second here. I'm gonna read the definition of, again, Black. It's an adjective, Middle English, bleak, as black skin, to OHG.bleak, i.e. base, bleak, shine, gleam, as in soot, smoke black from flame, opposite to white, see color, dark complected, Negro, totally without light, incompetent darkness, dark, soiled, dirty, wearing black clothing, evil, wicked, harmful, and disgraceful, sad, dismal, gloomy, sullen, engaged, without hope, as a guide, as a black villain. Just some of the definitions in the Webster's, in this Webster's New World Dictionary. And it goes down here, furthermore, to blackamoor. One, a Negro, especially an African Negro. Two, any dark-skinned person. Okay. And somebody might say, oh, see, they calling this black there. They say, oh, you a black moor. No, it's not what they're saying. Blackamoor. Okay, let me give you this analogy. If I had a French poodle, and my French poodle was the color black, and I was describing to someone that I have a French poodle, I would be describing the fact that I have a French poodle who the color he looks like is black. The description of his looks is black. His descent nature line would be French. He is a poodle of French descent nature line, meaning his mama was a French poodle from France, bred in France. So he has a nationality, more rights than the Negro. A French poodle, that's correct, has more rights than a Negro. Just because, and there's nothing bad about the word black if it's in its proper context. Because black does not describe your descent nature line from which you come. Okay? It describes what you may look like. Because if most of us looked at ourselves, our skins are dark brown, olive. The darkest complexion that looks black is really a deep shade of olive. Okay? Now, and for all those people who are stuck in the belief and will hold on for dear life that they are these fictional constructs, black, Negro, colored, African American, they have constructed something. It's called Silent Weapons for Quiet Wars. It's an executive order, 11490, King Alfred Plan, okay? Direct 84 Plan concentration camps, executive order 11490 expanded, top secret, silent weapons for quiet wars, inductory programming manual, operations, research, technical manual. This was not supposed to be released to the public. Union States of America Incorporated. Let me read this. The executive order number 11490, the Rex 84 plan, and silent weapons for quiet wars has been in the hands of the popularity since individuals calling themselves black leaders, since the early 1970s, many have spoken of them, but few have logistically broken them down and disseminated. Disseminated the information to their alluring public. The King Alfred Plan implicates the true motive and reason why they do not. One will take note that all people mentioned in these government plans, blacks, listen up, blacks, Indians, Latinos, Puerto Ricans, and so forth and so on, do not include a de jure national name or title. All these words are descriptive chattel brands coined by Europeans as substitute pedigree parentage names, as were forced as appellations on the indigenous peoples of the Americas. That's you and I. The indigenous, aboriginal, and indigenous to these lands is the copper-colored people that looks like you and me. The ones that Christopher Columbus saw when he got over here, and he called us Indians because he thought he was Indian, and he thought he was in India. Until this day, we still think we got Indian in our family when we are the Indians. Okay? One common thread is evident. No nationality means no equal rights and no human value. Are any of these states assigned black leaders speaking of or educating their people in recourse, readiness, remedy, or sovereignty? Do they instruct or do they not? This is the question. Okay? Let me go on here. Okay. Now, I'm gonna put that down. And further definitions, if you want to know what black is in law, you want to go to the Henry Campbell's here, Black's Law, 4th edition dictionary, to look up the same words in law, because what I'm learning through my studies is simply words connotatively that we've been taught that we think means one thing. In a common sense, in law, it totally means something totally different. So we go into these military tribunals that we call courts under these fictitious nomens, black, African-American, etc., to no avail, because you're already in a dead status under the jurisdiction of these codes and ordinances that are placed on the minorities. Now, I'm going to put on the record, I am not a teacher. I don't expect anyone to believe anything I'm saying. I expect you not to believe anything I'm saying. I'm just passing on information that it's my job to do. I'm supposed to pass on what I know to my brothers and sisters who are still perpetuating that vicious cycle. Marching, picketing, when we don't have to do any of that. The pen to paper is what we need to do. And for more information, for more knowledge on what nationality and birthrights is all about, because we are Moors. We are Moorish American nationals to the Americas. You know, North America, the North Gate, the Maghrib al-Aqsa, Northwest of Mexico, the North Continent. This is our land. We are the Akapa colored people to the land. And if you want to, you want more information, because this is for people. If you're not going to look, it means nothing. But these are for the people who want to know this information so they can better their conditions. Because we do not have to be treated like we're being treated. It's time to wake up. RVBayPublication.com. MHHS Blog Talk Radio every Tuesday. Eyes wide open. Okay, you want to go to Canaanland Moores, Grand Sheet, Cujo, Ottawa L, in Morris CivilLetter.net. Abdullah Mosey Bay will give you an excellent breakdown on etymology, the origin of words, you know, the words, so we can understand, and overstand the proper terminology of these words used against us in law. We must know these things. And stop allowing our people to be violated, because this is for the children. Any older people who you want to stick to being black, you want to stick to keep marching, you black and you proud, do what you do. More power to you. That's your power. But this is for the young and yet unborn. Our young people, we are not black people. Stand up. Islam, thank you very much for this time. Peace and love. Let's listen to this music on the way out. I love this song. And here are all some books here. RVBayPublications.com. Get your study on. Break down the Constitution. All kind of information here. A little artwork back here that I'm doing. My little artwork here. But peace and love.